Hello YouTube, this is Haru the Merchant, aka Artemir here, and I'll be doing this drawing demo. Due to a lot of requests from my coworkers, I'm going to skim over this mini spacecraft drawing. This video is sped up 5 times, so I'll be commenting on the important key points only. I hope this is somewhat informative. Starting off here with a small chalk brush on a gray background. I'm using Wacom Intuos 3 tablet, and this is Photoshop CC on Windows 7. Laying down initial construction marks. As you can see, the perspective is approximated. This style of perspective usage I call practical perspective. Since we don't plot points, we are just approximating. This style works well for sketching and even long-term drawings. The more you practice this form, the better and accurate your approximations get. Watching some basic perspective tutorials will really help you understand some of the principles used in this drawing. Modeling simple objects in a 3D software will also help you understand plane changes and 3D principles. After getting hang of it, you will be able to draw pretty much anything with fair accuracy. At this point, I have no idea what the design of the craft is going to be. So the whole design is just carved out of the simple rectangular box. For demo purposes, I'm going to keep the generic shape very simple and boxy. Since I'm drawing a 3D object in a 2D environment, it is crucial to clearly show the plane separations of the object. For beginners, I would strongly suggest to draw the horizon line with points and make a separate perspective grid layer to toggle on-off just to make sure everything checks. Even after several years of practice, it is very easy to make mistakes. When you practice a lot, your eyes become trained and you will be able to visualize the grid without drawing it. When I do matte paintings at work, I always have a grid layer toggle, just to make sure things are properly aligned, because sometimes you will get caught up with other things and forget about it. But for sketching, it is not necessary. This is a technical drawing. Drawing it in a 3/4 product view is the industry standard way to demonstrate this mini craft. Since we don't have a clear objective here, the functionality of the spacecraft is not relevant. It could be used in a video game as a tracking or spying craft to record information and bring it back to the base station. Putting A, B, C, mini box in the corner helps me check my drawing to make sure all the small and large separations are correctly placed within its corresponding plane. Usually, I will start off with thumbnails and pick the ones I like to make a detailed drawing out of it. Spending a good hour on a thumbnail design phase will help you to come up with much better and sophisticated designs, and having a reference always helps to make your design somewhat believable. But in this video, everything is on the go. There is no photo reference or initial thumbnail to refer to, hence the design is very generic. This is a hard surface object. Almost everything that we draw on it will have some sort of a thick metallic material. Having that in mind, whatever separations I make, as you can see, has a thickness. Shift-click and click-shift-click become your best friend at this point. Using the line tool in pixel mode is also a great way to go. Showing some of the inner parts of the object really helps to bring up the 3D aspect of it. It's a visual landmark that will make the viewer understand that the object has depth. Darkening the major plane changes is also a visual separation key. Line variations and line weight also play a key role in the overall look of the drawing. As you can see, I am zooming in now and adding some details, which are ultimately fillers to make the craft somewhat believable. In real-world situation, we would need a lot of functionality information to properly design. This is a good time to look at some reference materials to simulate an illusion that this object can possibly be real. Value. I stacked up a few duplicates of the drawing here to make the lines darker before adding value to it. Making a simple quick selection with polygonal tool and creating a merged copy of the drawing will help me here not to worry about the base value of the object. Also, the background now is freed up, so I can change the color and delete the extra lines that I don't need. And now I don't have to worry about getting out of the lines when I start brushing. By simply locking the layer, I can make quick selections of the desired plane and make it darker or lighter accordingly. Making few backup copies during the value process will ensure editing ability of the current changes. Using the lightness slider under Hue Saturation dialog box is a quick way to change the lightness of the currently selected portion. By making quick selections and throwing in some color with random brushes is part of the decision process to see where the spot color should go. Since I am not planning on fully coloring this object, only parts that I am going to play with the color are the parts that will have some sort of a light source. Strengthening the edges of the drawing with line tool helps the drawing to stand out as a single unified unit. Removing the extra unnecessary parts will also help the drawing look cleaner and stronger. Going back and forth to clarify the values of the plane is also very important to help the viewer understand the plane changes. Creating a copy and adding the wing on the other side of the craft helps the viewer to understand the perception of space because of the overlaps. Checking the perspective again, making sure it sits there without bothering the main design, helps the drawing to be more readable since we are creating visual hierarchy. Now I need to focus on the spot color or the lid parts of the craft as I mentioned previously. As you can see, I keep on changing the placements since they don't look that interesting to me. I finally decided to minimize the beam areas even more and just focus on the key parts, especially in the front. Keeping it simple is a good way to start off this process. It is always easy to work it out with a 3D modeler in case there is a need to add some more. Now that I'm somewhat okay with the light placements, with all these quick selections and dropping in color, let's come back and do the side wing adjustments. Flipping the canvas is another great way to check your work and see if everything checks out okay. This is a great time to do the final cleanups, touch-ups, and minor additions to complete the session. I hope this video was helpful and cleared up some of the technical things that we see a lot of the professional artists do really quickly and amazingly. Keep practicing and thank you for watching.